Hardly a week goes by that I don't get a call from someone in an organization saying, James, can you come in and do some work with us? Staff morale is quite low. And, you know, that's understandable. But it's always useful to remember that staff morale is a symptom. And if it's going to be dealt with, it's always useful to be aware of what the cause is. And in my years of experience of working in organizations on issues in this area, there's two or three causes that are always present. One of them, remembering low morale is a symptom. One of the causes is staff not feeling listened to, cared, appreciated, or understood. We all have the human need to feel valued and appreciated. And in the absence of it, cynicism or skepticism can take hold. One of the other reasons for low staff morale is what I would just generally call uncivil behavior. And this uncivil behavior often comes from the top down, or maybe it's, present within the organization, but it's not actually dealt with. Uncivil behavior is rudeness and aggressiveness and scapegoating and many of the things that we just wouldn't accept outside of a work environment. The last cause of low staff morale is communication vacuums. I've never been in an organization yet, where staff are saying, I wish management would stop communicating to us. It's never about too much communication. It's always about more quality conversations. That's what people are looking for. And maybe shaping meaning. So what the certain things mean to them. Because in the absence of quality conversations and communication, gossip will fill the vacuum, and gossip is never positive. So I hope these few little insights maybe shed a little light on the fairly common area of staff morale.